Hey, Box, I got 2 tickets to Star Wars on Thursday.
Oh, cool.
That's it? I thought you would be excited.
Well, RJ, I'm trying not to give my hopes up. Just trying to stay level-headed about the whole thing.
But it's Star Wars, Box.
Yeah, but to me, it's just another movie.
Gee. Okay, Box.
Huh? RJ!
Yeah, sir.
What's with the background?
Well, I figured we could use this background in celebration of the premiere of the new Star Wars movie. Boss, I figured you all people would be excited about this. I mean, wasn't Star Wars the first movie that your father took you to go see?
It's like I said before, I don't want to give my hopes up like I did back in 1999 with Episode 1.
Oh, Boss, it won't be the same. I mean, have you seen the trailers for The Force Awakens? They're pretty awesome.
Yeah, but the trailers for The Phantom Menace looked awesome too. I'm just saying.
You're still gonna go see the movie on Thursday night, though, right?
Well, I think I may wait till the crowd dies down in a couple of weeks.
But Bash, aren't you gonna do a review on it?
RJ, by the time I make my video, there'll be thousands of others with their own reviews uploaded. I mean, there's just no point.
But I got us lightsabers for the premiere.
Sorry, buddy, but I'm backing out on this one. You can go ahead and go and have fun with your plastic toys.
Come on, Bash, it even has lightsaber sound effects. See?
Dude, watch where you're swinging that thing. You almost hit me.
What was that, Bass?
Bass?
Bass, are you okay? Bass? Bass? Oh, dear.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, for another episode of Faceless Review. Starring your host, Faceless Critic, with co-host, RJ. Now put your hands together for Faceless Critic!
Hello and good evening, everyone. Faceless Critic here, and today we have an amazing review for you tonight. That's right, RJ. Today's review is groovy and far out.
That's what I said, man.
This flick I'm talking about was just released last night. Now, a lot of your theaters back at home may not have it just yet, but I heard through the grapevine that the studio company will have this movie playing in more theaters by the end of this weekend. And what movie am I talking about? Star Wars. There have been a few advertisements through TV and posters all around the city. There was even a novel that was written and adapted from this movie that was released last year. RJ, did you read the book?
Me?
Never mind. Let me give you cool cats the lowdown on this flick. The movie opens with the best orchestra score that I've ever heard in any movie that I've ever seen in my life. And get this, instead of credits like every other Hollywood movie, we get a basic narrative scroll like the old Flash Gordon serials. And it just basically tells us what's going on. After that, we're thrown right into the action with the bad guys chasing the good guys in space. And let me tell you all, seeing that huge ship fill the screen gave me chills, man. We then follow these two robots who are trying to escape from the battle. The little robot, R2-D2, is given some secret plans to the bad guy's battle station from this princess on board the little ship.
I don't mean to be a pervert, but I don't think she's wearing a bra, man.
I'm with you on that, man. The robots make their escape to the desert planet below, and for some reason go their separate ways. It's about this time we're introduced to the main bad guy, Darth Vader. He's the guy with the mask with a deep, scary voice and a breathing problem. He takes the princess as his prisoner and orders the rest of his men to search for the plans. Meanwhile, both of the robots get captured by these cloaked munchkin-type people and get sold to this desert farmer and his family. It's here where the main focus of the story turns to this young man named Luke Skywalker. He's fed up with his life as a farmer, and he wants to join the space army or something, but can't because his family needs him for one more harvest.
What do you suppose they're farming out in the desert?
Mushrooms, I think?
Oh, no way, man. I had one of those one time. I saw colors you wouldn't believe.
I don't think it's those kind of mushrooms. Later that night, the little robot runs away determined to complete his mission. So Luke and the other robot, C-3PO, go search for the little guy. They find R2 only to get ambushed by sand people, but they're rescued by an old man named Ben Kenobi. It's here we find out that old Ben knew Luke's father and that they served together in some war that happened years ago. Ben continues on telling the kid that both him and his father were Jedis, pretty much the peacekeepers of the galaxy. But because of Vader, all the Jedis are gone, including Luke's father. They then see a recording of the princess giving Ben a message to get the plans to her home world. Ben tries to convince Luke to join him in this adventure, but Luke pretty much says, "No way, Jose, man." However, thanks to fate, the bad guys follow the robots to Luke's farm, and they killed his uncle and aunt. With nothing left and no home, Luke decides to go with Ben. Convenient. They make their way to this spaceport, and I'll tell you what, I've never seen so many different aliens in one movie, man. Our heroes get a ride off the planet thanks to the space bungler Han Solo and his co-pilot Chewbacca. Basically an overgrown dog-like creature. Meanwhile, the bad guys are so fed up with the brawless princess that they decide to show the station's true firepower if she doesn't give up the location of the rebel base. She does give up the information, but the bad guys destroy her homeworld anyway.
Not cool, man. Not cool.
The heroes eventually run into the station where they rescue the princess. And let me tell you, I wasn't sure who was in charge of this operation. I mean, once she got out, she was calling the shots. Not so much a damsel in distress that we were led to believe. And I can dig that. Before they escape, Ben searches for Vader to settle an old score. And sadly, this is where Ben dies at the hands of Lord Breathalot. The rest of the crew, however, make their daring escape and go to their hidden rebel base, where Luke joins the rebel pilots and attack the battle station and destroy it. And that's the story. As you can tell from my enthusiasm, I love this movie. It reaffirmed my faith in Hollywood and science fiction as a whole. The special effects are fantastic, especially with the spaceship battles. I mean, I was looking for the strings and I couldn't find a damn thing. True movie magic. The story itself was simplistic, but at the same time it had so much depth that it just made this movie a true experience. The main actors and actress are really unknown for the most part. Well, the guy that played as Han Solo did play another movie back in 1973 called American Graffiti.
He's a bad kid.
But besides that, they played their parts pretty well, and it made me care about these characters. The man responsible for this classic in the making is George Lucas. It's rumored that he didn't think this film was going to amount to much. Modest man. Very modest. The music in this flick fit the tone perfectly, especially during the attack on the battle station. It had me on the edge of my seat. I'll tell you what, this movie is a huge success, and it wouldn't surprise me if they make a follow-up to it. I mean, hell, they did leave it open for another one, so cross your fingers, man.
If they do make another one, I'm gonna send a suggestion to have this as a weapon.
Whoa, is that a double-bladed light sword? Far out, man.
I know, right? Just imagine having this on you, man. You'd be one bad mother. Oh. Hey, man. You okay, man? You okay?
Oh. Holy hell.
Hey, boss. You're finally awake.
Yeah, I'm alright. What happened?
Well, I accidentally hit you with a lightsaber and you fell back and hit your head on the floor. But how do you feel?
I feel like I got a little ring in my ear, but other than that, I think I'm okay. I just had this weird dream. Like, you were in it and... No, it was just you.
You mean like 50 Shades of Grey?
What? No, it was just... It was something. But it wasn't bad.
Well, why don't you just take it easy and just get a little bit more rest? I'm gonna go and make you some soup or something.
Thanks, bud. Oh, RJ?
Yes, sir?
If that invitation's still open for Thursday night, count me in, buddy.
Do you mean it, boss?
Yeah, I mean it.
Yay! You know what, boss? I don't care what anybody else says. You're one far-out kid.
Wait, what?
Peanut butter disaster.